infectious disease is focused on people becoming sick because there's a germ that's getting into the body and causing a problem. There's actually a lot of bacteria and viruses living on the body in times of health. We didn't know this 10 years ago. And now we're starting to think that, oh, maybe a lot of these bacteria living on the body are what helps keep it healthy. So we're trying to get a better understanding of what the good bacteria are doing to maintain health. And we might be able to use them in our treatments.
I think one of the biggest challenges we face is antibiotic-resistant bacteria. I think that's probably our number one priority that a lot of groups here that actually focus on infectious disease. If you find out that you have a bacterial infection that is resistant to a particular antibiotic and you've been receiving that antibiotic, then obviously that infection continues and that can also induce further resistance.
With the continuous resistance, with not using the antibiotics appropriately, what will happen eventually if that continues is we won't have any antibiotics to treat, and people will die of infection.
So my research is in optimising dosing for paediatric patients. In the past, it's been very difficult to perform dosing studies in these patients because we need to collect multiple blood samples, and this presents quite a burden for a paediatric patient. So what we're looking at is we've got innovative tools for sampling called microsampling, where instead of collecting a large volume of blood, we can now collect just a drop of blood and use this to measure antimicrobial concentrations. We're one of the few groups that are taking it into clinical use because we can see the benefit to our patients of its use.
You're not going to die from a sinus infection, but our patients are particularly miserable. So just a bit of advancement in this area will affect so many people.
We look at trying to develop rapid tests so we can try and identify that bacteria quickly and also detecting the antibiotic resistance quickly as well.
Previously, we've been using sequencing, which normally takes 16 hours, 24 hours. The Accelerate system, we are definitely the first to have that in Australia. And with this, we can actually have an ID within a few hours instead. The clinicians are able to provide very specific care and specific antibiotics to treat the actual bacteria and in turn reduce mortality as a whole.
With the ear infections, we were working focused on Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Australians. It's most Indigenous babies are having these problems with chronic ear infections, and it's just horrible. I saw something with Bill Gates, and he was talking about he didn't want to give crutches to people with polio. He wanted to eradicate polio. And so I've always been attracted to that. I want to help people, but I want to help them by getting to the root of something in a really efficient way.